what I thought I would share with you is some, it's a technique for weaving anything. I was going to say locks, weaving locks into your yarn, but actually you can weave anything into your yarn, so long as it's flexible enough to wrap between the pieces of yarn. So I'm going to do this with a simple single, just a normal spun single from a bat, a carded preparation. I'm looking at it over here because this is a single. Once you've chosen your single, then you need to choose some things to weave into it. So this yarn's going to have a variety of different things. I'm holding my hand here and keeping this triangle here open. So these are my three strands. This is the loop, and this one here is the one in the middle. I'm going to keep those open, reach over, and I'm going to pick up a lock, give it a little bit of twist, and I'm just going to pop that in at the end there and start weaving it. So around and over and under, and I'm just going to keep going over and under. And the reason for keeping it open like this is not just to make it easier to weave into, but also to allow it to pop out the curls when I put it back together. So I'll show you how that works. So at the moment I've still got this big V shape here. Take that through the last piece. I'm going to add some twist. I'm just going to squeeze this back in here, add in the twist, and there is the locks integrated, well integrated into the yarn. It's not going anywhere. And because I held that V open, it lets these little locks poke out the sides when I pull it back in together. So I'll show you that again. Put the wrong orifice on my wheel. Go into the next area, hold it open. Add in a bit of twist. And then I'm just going to slide that in right up into the corner there and start weaving. So I put up underneath the middle one and then around the outside, back over the middle, around the outside. You can see the shape it's making there. I'll just pull it up a little bit. So I went over the outside, so now I'm going under the middle, back around, over the middle. So it's literally weaving into the triangle. And now I'll let that pull back in together. And there we have our next lock. And because I'm using the red yarn with the white lock, it gives a real contrast, so you can see how well that's locked into the twist. So I'm ready to put in another lock. So again, that's two. Let's drop that in that end. You can give it a couple of twists there if you want to, just to make it a little bit firmer. This is why I say it's quite a stop-start sort of process to weave these in. So if you're practicing your chain ply, this is a great chance to do it. Now if I've got nice little curly tips, I sometimes like to just leave those out so that it just adds a bit of interest to the yarn without having a really long lock hanging off the end, but you still get the advantage of the shape and the texture of it. So that's another one in. I'm going to try a bit of mohair next, just for the variety. This one's got nice curly tips too. I'm trying to do it without putting my hand over the top.
and leave those tips hanging out. So bring that ply back in together, and then we have a lovely curly piece. The lock's popped out like a little faux bouquet, and we tie's hanging off. Now remember when you're plying, just to manage that twist a little bit. Here I've got a very fine one here, I'll just pop this one in. So when you're chain plying, it's very easy to over twist accidentally. So what you can do, I'll show you in a sec, you can actually let some of that twist out. Now I'm just going to make this nice and wide so these pieces will pop right out. It's a fluffy little lock. And let that pull in together. What a nice texture that makes. To me, it sort of makes the most of those curls, having them in the weave like that, so they pop out little curly bits at the edges. But what I'm going to do now is put in this mohair. So this is just a mohair length. So I'm going to push that up into the corner and start weaving. You can do this with a two ply, only I feel like it just doesn't hold together as well as it does with this chain ply technique. With the two ply, it's still likely to pull out from in between the plies, because there's just not enough there to hold it in. It's just stuck in between two plies basically, and it's going to be very easy to pull out. So using this technique means that it really gets locked into place. As I pull this up, put some twist in, and see, I'm pinching here on this side just to make sure the twist comes into this area and doesn't jump over it. So keep a pinch on there and just make sure that locks in and the twist actually comes right through, and it's held these little curls in really nicely. I love the effect of the mohair because it just looks like little wavy clouds or like sea foam. I'll do another one. This is not a yarn that you want to rush. It's really nice and just actually quite mindful, just weaving through, looking at the shapes that it makes. I like the sort of ladder pattern that you get, and the sort of curly S shapes. And then it's quite satisfying when you go from this open V shape and then let it pull in close. Pinch it there, pull through some more yarn, and then add that twist. So the more extreme or the wider that V shape is, the bigger these loops will be. So I'll do one with a smaller V shape and you'll be able to see the difference between the size of the loops that it makes. I'll just get it started. Okay, so if I don't hold this as wide, first of all, it does take longer to wrap it through. Sort of pull this up as we go as well, sort of tighten it up more like a weaving. Gets pulled up, pull that in a bit, different sort of look. I did choose a long piece, didn't I? So here it is here with a much narrower V shape. I'll pull that in and it makes a much more compact, sort of tighter little curls area. So if you're making something that you wanted to look like bubbles, for example, this is a really nice way to do it, just by changing the width of that triangle. Here's another thing we can do with it, is actually just push it right up as well and kind of almost beat it like a normal weaving. I'll just get a few in to get it started. I'm going to keep the width on this. And then I'm going to push it up like you'd push up a weaving. Tighten it up. Keeping that shape. So the tightening up is to tighten it up that way, not across. So I don't want to pull it, I want to push it. And this way you can sort of make little flat panels in your yarn as well, which is quite sort of intriguing. It's like a sort of a flat bead, I guess. When I was first experimenting with this, I did some with two colors. So I started with a white and then did the other half in a green, and it ended up with a sort of a two colored bead in the middle of it. And see, this is really quite tightly woven. I could cut this off, but I think I like it hanging out like a little tail. It looks like a little mouse on here. And this is quite puffy, but it's also kept that shape that I wove into it. I'll get a piece of flat, sort of normal yarn, so you can see how that's going to look when it's woven flat. Get a nice enough piece. Okay. So I'm just going to weave this in and out. So I want to keep it nice and wide. Remember, we're pushing up, not pulling in. Just like weaving on a loom, you want to keep your selvages good. You don't pull it in too far, but you do want to beat it and push it up. So I'll just do a few more here. I guess it's a little bit like we've seen people over the years crochet into the yarn itself, which is a super cool technique, where you just take your single and as you're spinning it, you can crochet in a piece and make it basically any shape you like. And then you rejoin your fibre and keep spinning. Well, that's what we're doing here. We're not spinning it in, but we're weaving it in. So even though this is a little bit time consuming, it's totally worth it in the end, because you end up with something really unusual with some really interesting sculptural shapes. So I'll push this up. So it's quite firmly pushed up into sort of a almost a fabric that it makes, really. Now I'm going to start pulling it down and again to bring it back in. Okay. And I'll add the twist. And then you have this really interesting shaped addition. It's almost like a little flower. It's not coming out, it's got a little bit of movement in it, of course, but it's not going anywhere, and it's this really, really nice, loopy, puffy shape. Now, of course, this is another way of adding locks too, by the way. What you can do here is actually just kind of pull them up and let it sort of knot in there, and then just keep spinning, and there you've got a lock added, and that's not going anywhere. That's really, really firmly in there. Add in a bit more twist just to be sure. And this is another way you can add in those locks. Just push it up, just add in that end, and let it sort of form a knot around it. And sort of see there, it's twisted right in. So that's potentially a slightly more efficient way of adding in locks. I'll show you one more time with just my piece of mohair, because that was my last lock. So I just pull that in. Imagine this is the cut end. Pull it around a couple of times. This is slippery. You don't want to do so much that it loses its length. But see, now I'm just pulling that up into the middle and then adding the twist. And again, that's tied in there and it's not going anywhere. So that's another thing to play with. So just with one basic yarn technique, you can come up with all these different ways of adding in different types of fibers, locks, yarn, beads, tail spinning. There's always so much to explore. I really love to spend time practicing making different types of yarns and pushing myself to see if I can get just one more way of doing something, or alter the way I've been doing something to see if maybe there's another thing I hadn't thought of. It's really, really a nice challenge to come up with variations on a single theme in this way. So I hope you've enjoyed today's episode. I've just got to the end of my yarn. I'll take some photos of this so I can share it with you at the end of the video, and thank you for joining me.